obsessed ako dito sa Pilipinas, nag-i-import ng galunggong eh. Hindi ko talaga matanggap yan eh.
This is what President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. said when he explained why he had to seek Indonesia's help in improving the Philippines' fisheries sector.
I asked for help because matibay ang fisheries nila. So sabi ko, we can exchange delegations. That I think we can. Those are the things, especially in the agricultural sector, are going to happen in the very short term.
The Philippines began importing mackerel scad, locally known as galunggong, in 2018 after the small sea delicacy that was once known to Filipinos as the poor man's fish soared to almost 300 pesos per kilo. In January, the Department of Agriculture announced that the Philippines will still need to import some 60,000 metric tons of fish, including mackerel scad, to augment the expected shortage due to the pandemic and typhoons. Several experts blame the overfishing in the West Philippine Sea for the dwindling supply of marine resources in the Philippines, as Chinese fishermen continue to operate within the Philippines' exclusive economic zone. Marcos says he is open to exploring the possibility of closely collaborating with China to solve maritime disputes in the West Philippine Sea, noting that this strategy has been proven effective when the Philippines and Indonesia settled its border issues in the Mindanao and Celebes Seas in 2014. Meantime, aside from fisheries, agriculture, and border patrol, the Philippines and Indonesia will also work to deepen the bilateral trade between the two countries.
The trade between Indonesia and the Philippines increased by 50% in 21. Yun lamang, there's a trade imbalance really between Indonesia and the Philippines. So I said we should find ways to turn that around.
Before the end of his first state visit, Marcos spent time with Indonesian President Joko Widodo in the state-owned Sarina Mall in Jakarta as the Indonesian leader toured him in the establishment that houses small businesses that sell local products in Indonesia. Marcos says he is open to replicating the idea in the Philippines, where 99% of businesses are classified as MSMEs.
Very enthusiastic naman ng mga ministers ni President Widodo na sa yung mga prospects dito sa atin sa Pilipinas, and marami silang nakikita mga opportunities. So we will pursue that. I would describe the trip was extreme, more productive than we had expected.
Meanwhile, Press Secretary Trixie Cruz Angeles revealed investment figures gained by the Philippines during the Jakarta Business Roundtable meeting on September 5th. These include $822 million worth of investments in textile, garments, renewable energy, and agri-food, among others. $7 billion worth of investments in infrastructure for unsolicited private-public partnerships, and a $662 million trade value for supply of coal and fertilizer. Angeles adds they expect these investments to generate at least 7,000 new jobs. Katrina Domingo, ABS-CBN News, Jakarta, Indonesia.